Welcome into the premiere edition of Getting to Know the Smokies here, Climbing the Mountain edition. Matt Caesar joining us, Smokies outfielder. I'm Michael Watrang. And Matt, let's take us back to the Villanova days. You're juggling two major sports, baseball and football. What was that like?
It was pretty difficult. The hardest part was keeping up with my grades. I actually almost quit baseball my sophomore year, and just because it was really tough, you know. Football was my full scholarship, so I kind of owed it to them to stay to the football part of the program. But you know, it was tough because I was going to five classes, but in spring ball I was playing spring football and doing baseball as well. So for my body and mentally, it was taking a toll on me for sure.
Who was your influence to stick with baseball, even though it was that difficult?
You know what? It was the head football coach. He said, his name's Andy Talley, and he's like, hey, Matt, you know, you have a chance to be a hell of a baseball player, and, you know, you should stick with it. We'll figure it out. We'll make it work for you.
There's a lot of guys that never won a championship at any level, much less winning a football championship. Talk about that season and then the championship game.
That was a huge season. That was our junior year. You know, we had a great group of guys. The junior class and our senior class was even better, you know. And that was for the majority of the team, you know, was built around, you know, junior, senior guys. So it was huge. Everybody was very close to, you know, best friends, everybody. So it was a great experience.
Talk about the decision from leaving football and going strictly with baseball. You mentioned it was a scholarship to play football. That's kind of where your head was at. Talk about the decision when you sat down with your parents or whoever to make that decision to go baseball.
You know what? It wasn't very tough. You know, I feel like I was a football mindset until, you know, my junior, senior year when I realized that, you know, I could play baseball and hopefully play for a long time. You know, I had some injuries my senior year, and, you know, I had a great time playing in Boise. I signed my junior year, went to play in a short season. You know, I played, I think, about 25 games, had an awesome time doing that, and then I went back for my senior year of football to kind of, you know, make a deal breaker out of both of them, and, you know, I had a heck of a time playing baseball, so I just wanted to decide on playing the one.
You're so used to playing two different sports. Now that you're focused solely on one, what do you do in the off season to stay in shape and maintain your sharpness?
I still lift, you know, in baseball, you take off for swings a little bit for about a couple months. I actually this year played in the fall league, and that's about 2 months. And I took about a month off just lifting, and then I went back to baseball routine and started hitting again. Only 3 days a week, but it, you know, it's more than enough. And then once you get the spring training, you got to keep it all together.
Talk about now with the Smokies, you're one of the leadoff hitters, and talk about that mentality for being a leadoff hitter and really the table setter.
You know, the biggest part is, you know, having an approach, you know, making sure that the other guys on the team see what the other pitcher has to offer. And, you know, I just go up there and, you know, if I see my pitch, I'm going to hit it. But, you know, I try not to swing at bad pitches, try not to swing at all speed early on in the count, just so everybody else gets to see it.
Thanks for your time. Good luck this season.
Thank you.